Good morning to all of you. In previous lecture, I explained about the structure of power system, in which I explained the generating stations, the voltage level which we are generating over there, and we are using four transformer to transmit our power from one place to another place, then we have to distribute. First, we are using a step up transformer, then remaining we are using for step down transformers. What are the differences between a transmission line and a distribution line? So first difference is that in transmission line we have a high voltage, and second, we cannot connect our loads on transmission lines. Whatever the load we are connecting, that is always in distribution lines, and the voltage level of that distribution line is also less. Now I'm moving for our next slide. Here I'm talking about components of an electrical power system. So if we talk about the structure of power system, in which we used a lot of elements, or you can say components, for transmitting our power from one place to another place. First task is that we had to generate the electricity. Second task, to transmit our electricity. Third task, to distribute our electricity. Now in this lecture I am going to explain one by one what are the components I am going to use. So first, if I am talking about this generator, so I am using this generator over there. So everyone knows about the generator. It is a device which generates the electricity, or you can say which converts another form of energy to the electrical energy, because generation means you have to get electrical energy. Anyhow, you have to get electrical energy. And you know, energy neither can be created nor be destroyed. That means you are converting some form of energy to the electrical energy. So if you are talking about thermal power plant, so in thermal power plant we are using either coal, petroleum or gas as a heating elements, which is having the energy. So if you are talking about coal, so coal is having the energy in the form of chemical energy. Because chemical particles are bonded to each other with the, chemically bonded. So whatever the chemical bond over there, that is carrying some energy. And whenever this coal is fired, it will produce the fire. And this fire is having energy in the form of heat. And that heat energy is used for boiling the water. Boiler. We are providing this heat to the boiler, which boil the water. And it will convert into the steam, and this is steam which rotates the steam turbines, and directly with the steam turbines we are using the generators. These are turbo generators, and it will get the electrical energy. So I hope you got the point. So that how we are using the energy of other elements, coal. So we are using that energy which is having the form of chemical energy, because coal particles are bonded with the chemically bonded, and it produces in the form whenever it fire, it produces the heat. Heat is used for the boiling the water. Then it produces the steam. Then we will use this steam to rotate the steam turbine, and the steam turbine is directly connected to the turbo generators, which provide the electricity. So this is the procedure is happening. Means, what is the purpose of generator? Generator just generate the electricity. Means you can say this is the device which converts another form of energy to the electrical energy. Now if you are talking about transformer, so transformer basically, you know, either we are using for increasing the voltage level or decreasing the voltage level. That means we are using either for increasing our voltage or reducing our voltage. So what should be the main thing in transformer? That frequency should not be changed. Frequency should not alter. Always frequency is constant. So voltage level can be increased or decreased. And if we are talking about transformer, so most of the time, if we suppose that internal losses, that is a core loss is zero, if we suppose, if core loss are zero, so you can say that whatever the input power is there, that is equal to output power. Means whatever the electricity is supplied from the primary to the transformer, you will get the same power to output, means secondary side of the transformer. means in case of transformer, we can increase the voltage level or decrease the voltage level, but power should be constant and frequency should be constant. And you know, what is the power basically? So power is product of voltage and current if it is a constant. If product of voltage and current is constant, for example, so this is a constant. So if product of voltage and current are constant, suppose it is a constant, that means if we are changing the voltage, so definitely current will change. Current will change. So voltage and current both are reciprocal to each other, because voltage is inversely proportional to current. If we are increasing the voltage level, current level will reduce. So according to that, if we are changing our voltage level, either increase or decrease, according to the step up or step down, so current level will also change. So you can say in a short way that transformer is a device, a static device, which is used for either increasing the voltage level or decreasing the voltage level, or you can say the vice versa in case of current, either increasing or decreasing. But power and frequency should be constant. If we are supposing that internal losses, that is called core losses in case of transformer, that should be zero. Now now third point, that you got transmission lines. So we know in case of transmission line, basically is the a line, which a particular line which is made by a resistance and inductance, and somewhere we are having a capacitor also. We are talking about long and medium transmission lines. So this transmission line is allowed to flow the supply. So basically if we want to transmit our power from one place to another place, we are required this transmission line. Okay, so transmission line is basically transfer your energy from one location to the another location. Now we are talking about control equipments. So many control equipments we are using, like protectors, like different type of protectors we are using. Surge protectors we are using, earth guard we are using, that is earth protector, like bulb protectors we are using, and many more things we are using to control the device. Circuit breakers, we are using different type of circuit breakers, SFC circuit breaker, or oil circuit breaker, gas circuit breaker. A lot of circuit breakers are there. So all the things which comes under the control equipments, I will discuss these things in next slide in detail. Okay, now we are talking about primary transmission. So we know that transmission, primary and secondary, and distribution, primary and secondary distribution. This is basically classified in the terms of voltage level, and the second thing in the terms of load. In case of transmission, either it is a primary or secondary, load cannot be connected, and in primary distribution also load cannot be connected. Somewhere if you want, you can use some industry load on this primary distribution. But 99% loads we are which are connected to the secondary distributions. Okay, so for our purpose, the secondary distribution is required, because this voltage level, which is convenient for our domestic places, for three phase we are having near about 400 volt, and for a single phase we are having a 230 volt supply. So I hope you got these points. Okay. Now one by one I am going to discuss in detail, little bit detail. Suppose a first thing, generator, which generate the electricity, means if you are having your energy in other form, that can be converted in the electrical energy form. Like example, I told in the last slide that coal is having chemically bonded, it is having chemical energy, and whenever we burn this coal, it convert chemical energy to the heat energy, and that heat energy, which is used for boiling the water, which convert in the form of electrical energy whenever we supply that steam to the steam turbine, and that steam turbine is connected to the turbo generators. Okay, so voltage level, I already explained the different type of voltage level we are getting in case of generation. It may be 6.6 kb, 10.5 kb, 11 kb, or somewhere you can say 13.2 kb or 15 kb, so more than that. So in India, we are supposing that our average generation of electricity at 11 kV. So average, you can say generation voltage. The average generating voltage that we are having at 11 kV. Now we are talking about this. So this generating voltage can be step up or step down. So of course, with the use of transformers, either step up transformer or step down transformer, we can increase or decrease the voltage level. So after generating 11 kV, we can use the step up transformer, and we can increase the voltage level up to 220 kV. It depends either power transmission line is short, medium and long. So according to that, we can increase the voltage level. Okay, so if we are talking about rating of the generators, so we know generator can produce the power, that is a mega watt. Okay, and reactive power, that is MVAR, means we have to know the power, so power triangle. So I already explained in other subjects that you are having this power triangle. So if this power triangle is classified, so you can say, you can written like this, it is a perpendicular. This P is called active power. And the reactive power, which is perpendicular to active power, that is called reactive power. And this S, which is different the apparent power. Apparent power. Okay, so if you are talking about active power in the terms of mathematically, so you can write that VI cos phi. Now reactive power, that is VI sin phi. And this apparent power, that is V into I. So these are the power which is used everywhere. So in case of generator, we are having both two powers, like active power and reactive power. So reactive power unit, that is VI cos phi, that is megawatt. And second thing, if we are talking about reactive power, that is MVAR, megavolt ampere. Okay, so according to that, we can classify the power of generators which we are generating. Now the second thing, that is a transformer. So I already explained that transformer is a static device which is not movable, not a single part which we are having in case of transformer, that is a movable. So you can know that in a case of rotation system, we are having different type of losses over there. But in case of stationary, the losses are very, very less. That's why efficiency of transformer is very high. And efficiency of transformer are very, very high. So it is near about more than 92%. Some time you will get 97.8 to 99% also. It depends where we are using and which type of transformer we are using. Because in transformer, basically losses occur, that is a core losses. Core losses. And basically core losses, that is two types. There is a hysteresis loss. And another thing, that is an eddy current loss. Eddy current loss. So we know about this, that if we are talking about hysteresis loss and eddy current loss, we cannot reduce after the manufacturing of the transformer. So these things always take care by the designer of the transformer, which is design the transformer. Because during making the construction of core, we can reduce the hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. After that, we cannot. So whenever the transformer is ready to use, then after you cannot control the core losses. So that core loss is also called the fixed losses, because you cannot control it. It is always fixed. That's why it is also called fixed losses. Okay, so basically this is a static device, you know. So what is happening with this device? Basically this is change without changing the frequency, it can transmit our it can change our voltage level. Voltage, it can be changed, but frequency and power should be constant if we are supposing that core loss is nearly zero. So main function of transformer is either step up or step down, we know, either increase the voltage level or decrease the voltage level. So this is the things which we are using in case of transmission line. We are in case of transmission line, we are using two transformer. One is a step up transformer, which will increase the voltage level up to 132 kV. And another transformer which we are using for secondary transmission, that is a step down transformer, which will reduce the voltage level up to you can see near about 66 kV or 132 kV. Depends which type of transmission line we are using. So if we are increasing the transmission voltage, current flowing through this circuit will be reduced. So of course, I already explained that if we are talking about power, if it is a constant, mostly we are supposing that power which we are transmitting by the use of transformer, that is a constant. So if we increase the voltage level, current will also decrease. So this is a phenomena. So in this case, if we are increasing the voltage level in case of transmission line, because we are using a step-up transformer, and we are increasing the voltage level 11 kV to 132 or 230 kV. That means at the same proportion, current value will reduce. So if current value will reduce, so conductor size will reduced. So that is the concept over there. And if current is reduced and it flow to the conductors which is connecting the transmission line, so one loss is there, that is called I square R loss, that is also called ohmic loss. So if current value will reduce, this ohmic loss will also reduce. So if we are transmitting our power from one place to another place by the use of transmission line, and if we are using high voltage, so we are having a lot of advantages over there. First advantage that the size of conductor will reduce, the current which is flowing through the conductor will reduce, the cost will increase, cost will reduce, and one more thing that is very important, if current value will reduce and if current is flowing through the resistor, we know we are having ohmic losses. So I square R loss, that is a ohmic loss, will reduce. So this is the main concept to increase the voltage of transmission. This is the main thing. So that's why we are increasing the voltage level in case of transmission line. Now we are talking about control equipments. So basically we are having different control equipments. First we are talking about circuit breakers, which can break the circuit if it is having unwanted currents which is flowing. So we know if the short circuit will occur, so a huge amount of current will flow in the circuit. So if current value will increase automatically, so it will relay will detect the current and will break by the circuit breaker. So basically circuit breaker is very essential device in case of transmission line and distribution line, because anywhere two wires are touched to each other, that means there is a short circuit will occur. Huge current will flow at the point of short circuit. So anyhow, if we are not break the circuit with the use of circuit breaker, it will create a damage on that throughout the transmission line. Also, it can create the fire on that particular place. So that's why it is very important to use the circuit breakers. Okay. So that is called abnormal condition or fault condition. Fault condition means mostly fault will occur due to short circuit. We are having one separate module for this in power system 2. So we will discuss that fault conditions over there, that which type of faults will occur, either symmetrical fault or asymmetrical faults over there, three phase fault, line to line fault, line to ground fault, double LG fault, a lot of faults over there we will discuss later on. Now different type of circuit breakers. Of course, if you are talking about circuit breakers, it is not a single type. So we are having oil circuit breakers, air blast circuit breakers, vacuum circuit breakers, SF6 circuit breakers. All are the circuit breakers which we are not using in a particular place. They are having their specific characteristics. So according to the requirement and their characteristics which are matched with each other, then we are using the circuit breakers. So different type of circuit breakers which we are using in different type of connections. Somewhere we are using in SF6, somewhere we are using vacuum circuit breakers. Either in case of transmission, we are using different one. Secondary distribution, it is different one. Secondary prime transmission is a different one. So depends according to the requirement. So whenever we will discuss about these circuit breakers itself, there is one module in CNPG, then we will discuss about all the circuit breakers, which are the characteristics of these circuit breakers and what are the advantages of using, and what are the differences between all of the circuit breakers. Now during fault conditions, of course, the one fault will occur, short circuit will occur, so relay will give the command. So first thing we'll use, that is a relay. First the relay will give the command to the circuit breakers, and whenever it this damage will occur continuously for more than 0.2 seconds or you can say 2 microseconds, so it will open, or you can say circuit breaker will open. So first current will flow through the relay, and relay will feel that there is a huge current is flowing, and it will give the command to the circuit breaker. Yes, there is a fault is occurring because I am observing that it is not a normal current, it is an abnormal current. Whenever the abnormal current I am receiving, that means it can be damaged to the circuit. So how we can protect that circuit? Why not you will operate and you can cut out that circuit. So if circuit will cut out, current will not flow, so you can save that particular circuit. Now if we are talking about isolators, so isolators basically it is a you can say a manual circuit breaker. It is called a manual circuit breaker. is called manual circuit. A normal circuit breaker which operate automatically. When relay will feel the abnormal current, there is a short circuit, so it will automatically give the command to the circuit breaker and it will automatically work. Circuit breaker always work automatically, but isolators which will work on a you can say manual. So what do you mean by this manual? Manual means you as a person which are observing that some current is flowing in a particular place, some fault is occurring in a particular place, but circuit breaker is not observing that fault. So because whatever the circuit breaker you are using, for example, you are using 32 ampere circuit breaker and current is very, very small. So that circuit breaker is not able to detect that small current. So, but you are observing as that whatever the current should be present, you are not having that particular current. That means somewhere leakage is there. So for repairing purpose or reconstruction purpose, we are using these isolators. So what is basically isolators? Isolators is always used near about the substations. So in substations, if some problems is there, what we can do manually, we can open that isolators, and isolators, whenever we use isolators, it will isolate it from the main supply. If it isolates from the main supply, that means now we are not having any supply on a remaining part. So you can repair that remaining part, reconstruct your remaining part, and again you can connect to that particular supply which we are getting. So that is the work of isolators. So basically isolators are used for a maintenance purpose. So whenever maintenance is required, we are using these isolators, we can remove that circuit from the main set circuits. Okay, yeah, second thing, it operates only a no load condition. Of course, we cannot use in a on load condition, because if load is there, that means huge current is flowing through that particular circuit. And whenever you open that isolators on that particular load, so what will happen? It will create a spark. It will create a spark because you are breaking the circuit in a huge current. If huge current is flowing and you are breaking the circuit, that means automatically it will stop. Automatically it will stop at a certain time, and it cannot sustain that current should be break at a certain point. It can be you can say whenever current is not there, then you can remove that circuit. So you can say isolators basically use on a no load condition. So basically it's isolate switches are provided on each side of the circuit breakers. So that is called isolators. So you can just remember this point, that if we are using manually, that is called isolators. If it is work automatically, that means you can say it is a circuit breakers. And isolator is one type of circuit breaker, and isolators we are using on no load conditions. Now we are talking about bus bar. So what, first you have to know the, what is a bus bar. Suppose you are having this transformer. So a transformer is collecting the current, and it is passing through another circuit. So directly transformer which is not collecting direct current from anywhere. So what we are using? We are using bus bar. So just before and after the transformer, every time, just before and after the transformer, we are using this bus bar. Bus bar. Okay, so what basically bus bar is doing? Bus bar is collecting the current from one place, from destination to this particular point. जहाँ से भी करंट आ रहा है, इट इज ऑब्जर्विंग ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट एंड इट्स कलेक्टिंग दैट सेम करंट ऑन दिस बस बार. सो यू कैन से दैट बेसिकली बस बार इज वेरी वेरी रिक्वायर्ड थिंग्स. सपोज यू आर हैविंग वन सप्लाई विच इज कमिंग फ्रॉम हेयर. सपोज दिस इज जनरेटिंग वन एंड सम सप्लाई इज कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस प्लेस दैट इज जनरेटिंग टू. So you can connect both the supply on that particular bus bar, and it can add both the voltage level of power, and it can transmit to the transformer. So basically bus bar use as a grid system also. It is not a grid, but you can use as a grid also. It is not a grid, but you can use as a grid. So basically bus bar is used for collecting the current. So bus bar are used to connect number of lines operating at the same voltage electrically. So basically if power are different, suppose this is having P1 power, this is having P2 power, but voltage it is having V and V, both are same. So the same voltage you can connect on this point, and it can transmit to the transformers. And if we are construction wise, we want to describe this bus bar. So we are using the copper or aluminium to make this. And different type of bus bars arrangements are like a single bus bar arrangement, single bus bar with sectional adjacents, double bus bar arrangements, ring bus bar schemes. So a lot of connections are there, depends where we are going to use these bus bars. If suppose after the secondary distribution, if we want, we can directly use a simple single bus bar. But if we want to use for a grid system, means we are having a lot of connections over there. So for that, we are using this ring bus bar system. Or in this, basically what we are doing, we are making a ring, like a circular ring we are making. And everywhere bus bars are connecting, and any different supply which we are connecting with this, this is called a ring type of bus bar. Okay, so we will discuss these things on CNPG subject. Now we are talking about transmission system. So in case of transmission system, basically what is happening over there, just we are whatever the voltage we are generating that we have to transmit, so we are using that entire system for that. So basically in case of transmission, we need a bulk power, means we cannot talking about that we are having 1 watt, 2 watt, or 2 kilowatt. If we are talking about bulk power, means it is always in megawatt. Okay, so this is basically used for a big consumers. After the generation, we are using this transmission system. It connects the neighboring generating stations in a tower pool interconnections of two or more generating stations. So in transmission system, I already explained, suppose we are having this grid system. So in grid system, suppose you are having one member which is generating the electricity by a thermal power plant, for example. And here you another member which is generating the electricity by solar power plant, for example. Definitely they are having different voltage level on that particular point, different power they are having. But either we can use a transformer or something else, either we can generate the voltage level at the same amount. But whenever it reaches to the grid, its voltage will same. Voltage should same. So how you can make the same voltage? Of course, we can use the transformers over here. So by the use of transformer, we can make a same voltage level on that particular grid. And then we can transmit our power. So we can do this thing whenever we are having the transmission system. So in transmission system, we can connect the things and we can transmit our power on this way. I already explained about transmission system. We are having two transmission system, that is primary and secondary. So if we are talking about primary transmission, so main thing which we are explain on this transmission system, that is a voltage level. Okay, so if a generating power is transmitted through transmission line without stepping up the generating voltage, the line current and power loss would be very high. So I already explained, if the voltage level is near about 11 kV and we want to transmit that power at 11 kV, so current value will be very high. So for this high current, we need a thick conductors. So conductor weight will high. So if conductor weight will high, cost will also increase. Cost will also increase. And of course, if current is very high, so if resistance is there in the conductors, so always ohmic loss, that is I square R loss, is there. So due to high current, ohmic loss will increase. So of course, power loss will occur when we are not increasing the voltage level. So main thing, we have to increase the voltage level. And what is the scenario, which how much voltage we are increasing? So we are increasing either 132 kV or 230 kV or more than that, depends on which type of transmission line we are choosing. So most of the time we are increasing 230 kV because if we are having long transmission lines. Now, so generated voltage is step up a higher value using the step up transformer located in substations known as the sending and substations near to the generating stations. Means we have to increase the voltage level, and its voltage level near about 230 kV or 132 kV. High voltage transmission line transmit power from ascending and substations which is receiving. Of course, if one place you are sending, suppose from here you are sending the power, you are using the transformer, and this is called sending transformers, because you are increasing the voltage levels from 11 kV to 132 kV or 230 kV. So you can say this is called a primary transmission. This is called primary transmission. So this is sending. This is a sending end. This is a sending end. but somewhere you will receive. So where you will receive, that is called step down transformer, and this place that is called secondary transmission. This is called secondary transmission. So in this case, this is a sending, but this transformer which is a receiving. So of course, if from one place you are sending, so another place you will receive. So after increasing the voltage level, you are sending the power, that means this is called sending end. And just transformer we are using, and bus bar is also is there, just behold the transformer. And this point where we are collecting this current or this supply, that is called receiving end. So primary transmission voltage near about 110, 132, 220 kV or more than that. Okay, so depends which type of wires we are using, which type of connections are there. So depends on that. Yeah. One more thing I want to explain that we are having different type of connection, like a single phase two wire system, single phase two wire, midpoint grounded. Okay, now like a three phase, we are having two phase four wire, two phase three wire system, then we are having three phase three wire system, three phase four wire system. So different connections are there. So in case of primary transmission, we can use only three phase three wire system. That you have to remember. Three phase three wire system we have to use, because three phase four wire we are required only when we want to use that supply on your domestic places. So whenever we want to use in domestic places, we need a neutral point. So we are a three wire we are using for phase, and one remaining wire that is used for neutral point. So where you want to use your load, there only we are using three phase four wire system. So three phase four wire, basically we are using secondary distribution, but other than secondary distribution, we can use three phase three wire system. Now secondary transmission. So at the receiving end substations, the voltage is stepped down at the value is 66, 33 and 22 kV. I already explained. We are using a step down transformer. So out of four, first is a step up, and remaining all three transformers which we are using in case of structure or power system, that is always step down transformers. The secondary transmission line forms the link between the receiving and substations and the secondary stations. It is used three phase three wire system. I already explained that a three phase four wire we are using in secondary distribution. Other than that, everywhere we are using three phase three wire system. Okay. Now we are talking about distribution system. So in distribution system, basically the components of an electrical power system connecting all the consumers in an area to the bulk power source or transmission line is called the distribution system. Means in distribution system, you can connect the load. But in if voltage level is very high, so in that particular point you cannot connect your domestic loaded, but you can use. And whatever the area where bulk power source is there, so that is also called a distribution system. A distribution station distributes power to the domestic, commercial and relative small consumers. So of course distribution is used for the domestic places, commercial uses, industry and every purpose. Means it is just supply the voltage to the directly to the consumers. Distribution transformer are normally installed on poles or non-plinth mounted or near consumers. So of course wherever we are required that supply, so near to that particular point we are using this type of transformer. I think you all know that in your domestic places, suppose you where you are staying over there, so just nearby you are having one transformer. So that purpose of that transformer to reduce the voltage from 11 kV to 440 kV for a three phase supply and 230 volt for a single phase supply. So I hope you all know these things, that you are having the transformer that is called secondary distribution transformers. Now a primary distribution, if you are talking about, so we know that we have to decrease the voltage level up to 11 kV or less than 11 kV, near about 6.6 kV. Of course, we are using step down transformers. Primary distributors forms the link between secondary distribution and distribution substations, and the power is fed into the primary distribution system. So after whatever the power is transmitting by the secondary transmission, that we are receiving with the primary distribution. So we are having substations where we are receiving that power which is transmitting through the secondary transmission. So here also we are using three phase three wire connection. I already explained, because here we cannot we don't want to connect any load. So if we don't want to connect any load, so what we can do, we can use a three phase three wire system. And if we want to connect the load, we can connect, but we can connect this load on industry only, industry or forums where only three phase supply is required. We can use three phase supply we can do, because neutral is not there, because neutral is not there. Now if we are talking about secondary distribution, at the distribution substations the voltage is stepped down to the 400 volt, because we are required near about 400 to 430 volt for three phase supply and 230 volt for a single phase supply. Of course we are using step down transformers. The distribution lines are drawn along the roads, and service connectors to the consumers are tapped off from the distributors, so directly we can connect the load on this particular line, that is called secondary distribution. Here you are using three phase four wire system. Okay, so single phase load are connected between the phase wires and neutral wires. So what basically we are doing, suppose we are having three phase supply over there, R, Y, B supply is there. Three phase just represented with R, Y, B, red, yellow and blue, and all are having 120 degree phase shift. This supply is coming from secondary distribution, for example. But if it is a three wire only, it is a three phase and three wire system, and you are having your domestic load, suppose this is your domestic load. So what you will do, suppose you want to connect one wire with this R phase, then where you will connect your second phase, because when if you connect over here, so you will get two phase over there. So both conductors you are having phase. That means here you are receiving near about 400 volt supply. So if you are receiving 400 volt supply, but your appliances which is designed for 230 volt supply, is it work? No, it will damage to this appliances. Every appliances will be damaged by this supply, because we need 230 volt supply. But if we are talking about this line to line voltage, because if we are talking about voltage in between of any two phase, that is called line voltage, VL, line voltage. Line voltage means voltage between any two phase. So if R phase and Y phase is there, and we are connecting between R and Y, that means we are getting two phase. So if we are applying a two phase supply on this particular point, that means we are having line voltage, and our appliances which is not capable to sustain 400 or more than 400 volt. So it will damage the supply. Means here where low single phase load is required, we cannot use three phase three wire system. So for that we are required three phase four wire system. So on the top I'm making this. Suppose you are having this three phase, so R, Y and B, and one point is there which is for neutral. Suppose you want to connect your load, there is a primary load is there. Suppose you are connecting one with your R, the R phase is there, and when you will connect with the neutral, means the voltage in between of this phase and neutral, that is called phase voltage. That is called phase voltage. It is represented with VPH. So R or N ke beech ka voltage ko kya bolenge? Phase voltage, because it is between R phase and neutral. So it is only single phase. So now your appliances is getting 230 volt supply for a single phase. So now there is no any problem. Some other people circuit is like this, so they can connect like this. Suppose here they are connecting, and they are connecting with this phase and this neutral. This is absolutely right, no problem with this, because again you are having a single phase and single neutral, you will get 230 volt supply, so there is no any problem. Some other people which they can connect like this, that remaining a phase is there, this one Y phase is there, so they can connect with the Y and they can connect with the neutral. There is no any problem. This is absolutely right. So they can take a one phase and one neutral, and they can connect for a single phase. But if you want to connect this entire thing for a three phase system, so for a three phase system, what they can do, they can use a three-phase connections, and they can connect these three-phase with this R, Y, and B. All three-phase they can connect together, and they can take as a three-phase supply. There is no need to connect a neutral. But if this load is a star load, because there is a difference between the star and delta load, because suppose if we are having this delta, look, if we are having delta, means in delta we don't have any neutral point. So for if we are having only three wires, we can directly connect these three wires on this. But if we are having a star load, so for a star load we are having a neutral point. So if we want to connect, we are having four wires. So for four wires, we need R, Y, and B phase. And one we have to connect with the neutral. So you can connect your three phase supply also. That's why this at a secondary distribution mostly we are using three phase four wire system, where we can use for a single phase as well as three phase loads. So it is also called mixed load system, where you can use for your domestic places as well as you can use for industry purpose. So this is all about the lecture. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed the lecture.